Okay, today we'll start the next chapter, work, energy and power. Okay, so first we start with the first physical quantity, which is work. Okay, now there are two necessary conditions for the work to be done. Okay, and what are those necessary conditions? The first one is the force should be applied. Necessary conditions for the work to be done. The first one, force should be applied. Okay, some external unbalanced force should be applied. Then only the work is said to be done. And the second one is, the body should be displaced due to that force. Okay, body should be displaced, should move from that point. So, it should be, body should be displaced. Then only we say that the work is done. Okay, only under these two conditions, then we say that the work is done. Otherwise, though the force is applied, but if there is no displacement, then the work done is zero. So these are the two necessary conditions for the work to be done. That is, the force should be applied, and also due to that force, the body should be displaced. Okay, so work is depending upon these two physical quantities, force and displacement. So here, work done is defined as the product of force and displacement. Force and displacement, both are vector quantities. So work done is the dot product or the scalar product of force and displacement. It is the dot product of force and displacement. That is F dot S. Two vectors are multiplied, but the product is a scalar quantity. So work done is force dot displacement vector. Okay. If the angle between force and displacement is theta, then it can be written as F into S into cos theta. Let this is the direction of the force and the body is displaced along this direction. Okay, so there is some angle between force and displacement, then the work done will be equal to force into displacement into cos of angle between them, cos theta. So work done is the dot product of force and displacement, which is equal to F into S into cos theta if there is some angle between force and displacement. If you are applying the force and the body is displaced along the same direction, that is theta is equal to 0 degree. Okay, you are applying the force along this direction and the displacement is also along the same direction. Then we say that the work done is the product of force into displacement. Why? Theta is equal to 0, so cos 0 is equal to 1. Then it will be equal to F into S. Okay, now we come to its unit. The SI unit of work is, from the formula, you see that Newton into meter. So it is Newton into meter, which is taken as joule, called as joule. So 1 Newton into 1 meter is equal to 1 joule. So 1 joule of work can be defined as when a force of 1 Newton displaces the body through 1 meter along the direction of force. That is, theta should be equal to 0 degree. So 1 joule of work is done when 1 Newton of force is applied to displace it through 1 meter along the direction of force. Then we say that the work done is 1 joule. Okay, so write it in the same manner. The necessary conditions for the work to be done are force should be applied. The second is body should be displaced. So work done is dot product of force and displacement vectors. Work done is dot product of force and displacement vectors. If angle between force and displacement is theta, then you can write it as F into S into cos theta. SI unit of work is joule, where 1 joule is equal to 1 Newton into 1 meter. Let us define 1 joule. Write down, 1 joule is defined as, 1 joule is defined as the work done. 1 joule is defined as the work done when one newton of force displaces the body through 1 meter along the direction of force. So 1 joule is the work done when 1 newton of force displaces through 1 meter along the direction of force. That is theta is equal to 0 degree. Okay, CGS unit. In CGS system, CGS unit of work is ergs. CGS unit of work is ergs, where 1 erg is equal to, the force will be in CGS system, which we take it as dime. When a force of 1 dime displaces the body through 1 centimeter along the direction of force. So the CGS unit of work is erg, where 1 erg is equal to 1 dime into 1 centimeter. Okay, so you can define 1 erg. 1 erg is the work done. 1 erg is the work done when a force of 1 dime, when a force of 1 dime displaces the body through displaces the body through 1 centimeter along the direction of force. Now let us find the relation between joule and erg. Joule is the SI unit of work. Erg is the CGS unit. Okay. 1 joule we know is equal to 1 newton into 1 meter. In order to get it in ergs, newton has to be converted in dimes in the CGS system. The unit of force in CGS system is dime. And meter has to be converted in centimeters. Okay, and 1 newton is equal to 10 raised to the power 5 dimes. 1 newton is 10 raised to the power 5 dimes. And 1 meter is 100 centimeters. 100 centimeters can be written as 10 raised to the power 2 centimeter. So 10 raised to the power 5 plus 2, 10 raised to the power 7, dime into centimeter, and dime into centimeter is called as ergs. So 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to the power 7 ergs. So here I am writing 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to the power 7 ergs. So the relation between joule and ergs, the SI unit and the CGS system of unit of work is joule and ergs respectively. And 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to the power 7 ergs. Okay, how to convert? Convert newton in dimes. 1 newton is 10 raised to the power 5 dimes. This we had already discussed in the previous chapter. And 1 meter is equal to 10 raised to the power 2 centimeter. So, convert it and you get it as 10 raised to the power 7 dime into centimeter, and dime into centimeter is ergs. So, 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to the power 7 ergs. Okay, now comes the nature of this quantity. As work is the dot product of force and displacement, it is the scalar product of force and displacement. So work done is a scalar quantity. So write down, as work is dot product of force and displacement, so it is a scalar quantity. So work is a scalar quantity. Okay, that is, it doesn't have any direction. Okay, only it has got magnitude. Okay, let's find the dimensions also. What will be the dimensional formula of work? Dimensions of work. Force into displacement. Force has got a dimension. MLT raised to the power minus 2 into L. L into L, L square. So M, L raised to the power 2, T raised to the power minus 2. So the dimensional formula of work is M, L raised to the power 2, T raised to the power minus 2 is its dimensional formula. Okay, now in rectangular components, how can the work be written? This we have already studied in scalar product. Okay, in chapter number 4, scalar product. If force is given in 3 dimensions in its rectangular components, that is force is having all 3 components along x, y and z axis. So it can be written as F x into I cap, F y into j cap, plus Fz into k cap. And the displacement vector is also in 3 dimensions. So the displacement along x axis, let it is x, I cap, y into j cap, plus z into k cap. Okay, now work is force dot displacement. Okay, we have already studied I dot I is 1. So it will be equal to F x into x, F y into y, plus F z into z. Is the work done in rectangular components if force and displacement are given in rectangular components? So here you can see that no I cap, j cap or k cap are coming. Work is a scalar quantity. I cap, j cap, k cap, these are giving the direction. So here in this result, force dot displacement vector, there won't be any vector sign, no I cap, no j cap or k cap. So in rectangular components, work can be given as Fx into x, Fy into y, and plus Fz into z. Okay, so work is a scalar quantity and it is the dot product of force and displacement. Okay, and dimensional formula we have studied, which is m l raised to the power 2, t raised to the power minus 2. SI unit is joule, CGS unit is ergs, where 1 joule is equal to 10 raised to the power 7 ergs. Okay, now let's study the nature of work. That is, the work done can be positive, negative or zero. Work can be negative also. But here negative work done doesn't mean that it has got a direction. Work is a scalar quantity. It has got only magnitude. Okay, so write down nature of work. Nature of work. Write down work done may be positive, negative or zero. Work done may be positive, negative or zero. Okay, first we'll discuss positive work. Okay, we know that work is force into displacement into cos of angle between them. Here if cos theta is positive, then the work done is positive. And when is cos theta positive? When theta is less than 90 degree. Theta, acute angle, less than 90 degree. Cos theta is positive, so the work done will be positive. So when theta is less than 90 degree, work is positive. Why? Because cos theta will be positive, cos less than 90 degree is positive, so the work done is positive. Okay, so it is depending upon cos theta, upon theta. Theta less than 90 degree, cos less than 90 degree is positive, so the work done is positive. Let's discuss few examples of it. Okay, if theta is equal to 0, cos 0 is equal to 1. Okay, for example, a block kept on the table, you apply the force along this direction and the displacement is also along the same direction. So what is the angle between force and displacement? 0 degree. Okay, so the first example is in pushing a block kept on the table. In pushing a block kept on the table. Okay, like this figure. So here theta is equal to 0 degree and cos 0 is equal to 1. So the work done is force into displacement. It will be positive. Okay, second example. A child pushing a toy car. Okay, let this is a toy car. A child pushing this toy car along this direction, along a a thread is tied to this toy car. So the child is pulling this car along this direction, along the direction of the rope or the string, but this car will be displaced along this direction. So again, what is the angle? Theta is less than 90 degree, so cos theta will be positive and hence the work done will be positive. Okay, so here we are finding out the work done due to the applied force. It is very, very necessary to mention the force, the work done by the force which is applied by the child, the work done by the applied force to move the body. Another example, let a body is dropped from a height h. A body is dropped from a height h. Let us find out the work done by the gravitational force. We know that gravitational force acts in the downward direction. Okay, it is due to the gravity. So the gravitational force, which is the attraction due to the earth, is acting in the downward direction, and the displacement is also in the downward direction. So when a body is dropped from a height h, the work done by the gravitational force is positive. The work done by gravitational force is positive. So a body dropped from a height, the work done by gravitational force, is positive. Why? Because both are in the same direction, angle is 0 degree. Okay, now the work done may also be negative. Negative work. When is the work done negative? When cos theta is negative. And when is cos theta negative? When theta is greater than 90 degree. So when theta is obtuse, that is greater than 90 degree, then cos theta is negative. So work done is negative. So when cos theta is negative, and when is cos theta negative? When theta is obtuse angle, that is greater than 90 degree, then the work done is negative. Okay, now let's see few examples. Okay, the work done by any opposing force will be always negative. Okay, in this block, applied force, due to the applied force, the work done is positive. But in which direction is the frictional force acting? Opposite to the applied force. So if we find out work done against the friction, work done by the frictional force, displacement is along this direction, frictional force is in the opposite direction. So what is the angle between force and displacement, frictional force and displacement? It is 180 degree. Okay, it is 180 degree. We are not finding out the work done by the applied force, work done by the frictional force. Okay, frictional force and displacement are in the opposite direction. So theta is 180 degree and cos 180 is minus 1. Cos 180 degree is minus 1. So the work done by the frictional force is negative. By any opposing force, by any resistive force, the work done will be always negative. So write its examples. First example, the work done by frictional force. The work done by frictional force in moving a block. Work done by frictional force in moving a block is negative. Why? Because theta here is equal to 180 degree and cos 180 is minus 1. Okay, so the work done is negative when theta is, that is work done by the frictional force. Okay, when the brakes are applied in a vehicle, okay, the work done by the braking force will be opposite to the motion of the vehicle. In which direction does the braking force act? Opposite to the motion of the car, opposite to the motion of the displacement of vehicle. So again, theta is equal to 180 degree. So the work done by the braking force in vehicles is negative. So write the second example. Work done by the braking force. Work done by the braking force in vehicles. in vehicles is negative. Okay, another example. When a particle is thrown vertically upwards, an object is thrown vertically upwards, any ball, anything is thrown vertically upwards. Here displacement is in the upward direction and we are finding out the work done due to the gravitational force. In which direction is the gravitational force? Gravitational force always acts in the downward direction. So gravitational force is acting in the downward direction and the body is being displaced in the upward direction. So what is the angle between gravitational force and displacement? 180 degree. And cos 180 is minus 1. So what is the work done by the gravitational force in this case? It is negative. So write down, when a body is thrown vertically upwards, when a body is thrown vertically upwards, the work done by gravitational force, the work done by gravitational force is negative. The work done by gravitational force is negative. Okay, also the work done can be zero. When is the work done zero? The third one is zero work. Okay, now there are two conditions for zero work. The first one is if the displacement is zero. Okay, though the force is applied, but if the displacement is zero. So zero work, if displacement is zero, then work done is zero. Or if theta is equal to 90 degree, cos 90 is zero, then also the work done is zero. So under two conditions, the work done can be zero. If the displacement is zero, then the work done is zero. And if the angle between the force and displacement is 90 degree, then also the work done will be equal to zero. Let's see few examples. First example, displacement is zero. Any immovable wall or any immovable rock, a heavy rock, a mountain, a wall which cannot be moved. If you keep on applying the force, but the displacement is zero, so the work done is zero. Okay, so write down, in pushing an immovable wall, immovable wall or immovable rock, anything you can write down, in pushing an immovable rock, work done is zero. Why work done is zero? Because the displacement is zero. Now theta equals to 90 degree. Okay, a pulley holding a heavy box on his head moving on the platform, the work done by the gravitational force, work done by the gravitational force will be zero. Okay, pulley is moving with a constant speed in the forward direction. So this is the direction of the displacement and the gravitational force is acting in the downward direction. So the angle between the gravitational force and displacement is 90 degree. And hence the work done will be equal to zero. Okay, so write the second example. A pulley moving on a platform with heavy load on his head, with a heavy box on his head, the work done by gravitational force is zero. The work done by gravitational force is zero because theta is equal to 90 degree. Okay, another example. The work done by centripetal force is always zero. Work done by centripetal force is zero. we know that centripetal force comes into play when the particle is moving in a circular path, and the centripetal force is acting towards the center, and at every point you can see that the displacement will be perpendicular to the centripetal force. Displacement by drawing a tangent at that point. Why? Because if a body is released, it will move tangential at that point. That is, the displacement is perpendicular to the centripetal force. So the angle between the centripetal force and displacement is 90 degree, and hence the work done due to a centripetal force is always zero. So the work done due to a centripetal force is zero. Okay, so the work done may be positive, negative, or zero. Okay, next we'll discuss how to find out the work done by graphical method. Okay, now let's find out the work done by graphical method.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, if a frictional force is applied, static friction, then also displacement will not be there, no?
Your voice is not...
Ma'am, if static friction is applied, if static friction is present, then displacement will not be there.
Static friction is there, displacement will not be there. Yes, sir.
Then also the energy is zero.
Then also the work done due to static frictional force. Okay, that can be taken as because the body is not moving. Displacement is not there.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now work done. Unmute yourself, some of you. Unmute everyone. Okay, work done by graphical method. If a constant force is applied, constant force means the magnitude of the force is not changing. The magnitude of the force is constant. Then the work done can be determined by area under the line. It is force into displacement. Okay, this force is constant force. When a constant force is applied, work done is equal to force into displacement. And how will you get force into displacement? By finding out the area covered under the line. Okay, how to find out? Area under the line will give you the work done. Area under the line will give the work done. But when a variable force is applied, variable force means the force is changing with the time. The force is not constant. It may be 2 Newton, 10 Newton, 100 Newton, anything. It's changing. Okay, let this is the variable force. Any way you can draw it, let this is the variable force which is continuously changing with the time. Okay, then how to find out the work done? We consider a small strip whose displacement is a very, very small displacement, ds. For this displacement, we consider the force to be constant and we find out the area. This is the small work done. Okay, let the small work done is dw, which is equal to f into ds. That is area of the strip. Area of the strip will give the small work done for this small displacement. Okay, this way. We'll divide it into a number of strips. We'll add all these areas. So the total work done will be the summation of all the areas of these strips. Summation of all these areas, it means what do we do? Integration. In physics, this continuous summation means it is integration. So it is the integration of F into ds. So whenever a variable force is acting, the work done will be the integration of F into ds. Constant force acting, directly you can, as it is a geometrically shaped figure, rectangle, you can find out the area of the rectangle, force into displacement. Okay, but here you have to find out the area of each strip and then summation of area of all these strips. And summation here means integration. So the work done will be the integration of F into ds. Okay, depending from what displacement to the other, let here it is x1, x2, then the limits will be from x1 to x2 or s1 to s2, or from here you are finding out 0 to s, the limits will change according to the displacement. Okay, so here we are not writing the limits. Work done is equal to integration of f into ds. Hurry up, note it down.